What is the reason behind the brilliance of diamonds? What is the reason behind the formation of mirages? What is the basic principle behind working of optical fiber? For these three questions, only one answer, that is total internal reflection. By doing an activity, we are going to know about critical angle and total internal reflection. For this activity, we need a plan covered by white chart, semicircular glass disc, circular protractor, and laser light. Take a wooden plank which is covered with white chart. Draw two perpendicular lines passing through the middle of the paper. Mark horizontal line as MM while vertical line as NN. Draw a circle and mark angles from 0 degrees to 90 degrees in 4 quarters of the circle by using a circular protractor. Now place a semicircular glass disc so that its diameter coincides with the line MM. Here, glass disc is denser medium and air is rarer medium. The line MM is interface of the two media and the line NN is normal. When we send laser light through glass disc, it bends away from the normal. Why? Because it travels from denser to rarer medium. At the same time, some part of light reflected into the glass disc. Here, there are three angles, that is, angle of incidence, angle of refraction, and angle of reflection. Let us observe carefully. When we increase the angle of incidence, the refracted angle also increases respectively. But at certain angle of incidence, the refracted ray grazes the interface of the glass and air. After that, refraction does not take place. Totally, the light reflected into the denser medium. This phenomenon is called total internal reflection. Once again, we will understand about critical angle and total internal reflection by using images of this activity. When light ray passes through the normal, does not deviate. When light passes through 10 degrees, it refracts at 15 degrees and some part of light reflects at 10 degrees. When light passes through 20 degrees, it refracts at 30 degrees and some part of light reflects at 20 degrees. When light passes through 30 degrees, it refracts at 50 degrees and some part of light reflects at 30 degrees. When light passes through 40 degrees, it refracts at 80 degrees and some part of light reflects at 40 degrees. Observe carefully. When light ray passes through 42 degrees, refracted ray grazes the interface and some part of light reflected into the glass slab at 42 degrees. So, 42 degrees is the critical angle of the glass slab. Therefore, critical angle is defined as the angle of incident at which the light ray traveling from denser to rarer medium grazes the interface is called critical angle for denser medium. When the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, refraction does not take place. The total light ray is reflected into denser medium. This phenomenon is called total internal reflection. Now we are going to understand the reason for brilliance of diamond. The critical angle of diamond is very low, that is 24.4 degrees. So if a light ray enters a diamond, it is very likely to undergo total internal reflection, which makes the diamond shine. Do you know about mirages? Mirage is an optical illusion where it appears that water has collected on the road at a distance place. But when we go there, we don't find any water. During a hot summer day, air just above the road surface is very hot and the air at higher altitudes is cool. Here, hot air acts as rarer medium, while cool air denser medium. When the light from tall object such as a tree or from sky passes from cool air to hot air, it takes a curved path because of total internal reflection. This appears to the observer as if light ray is reflected from the ground. Hence, we feel the illusion of water being present on the road. These are optical fibers. An optical fiber is very thin fiber made of glass or plastic. Even there is a bending, light is transmitted along the fibers from one end to another end. Let us observe the transmission of light in optical fibers. Here, we are inserting some optical fibers into a pipe. Observe here, light is transmitted from one end to another end through the optical fibers which are inserted in the pipe. Even though there is bending, light is transmitted through optical fibers. How is it possible? This is due to total internal reflection. When light enters into optical fiber, it makes a nearly glancing incidence on the wall. The angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, and hence total internal reflection takes place. Thus, the light is transmitted along the fiber. By using optical fibers, endoscopic light pipe is prepared. Doctor inserts the pipe into the stomach through the mouth. Light is sent through one set of fibers in the light pipe. This illuminates the inside of the stomach. The light from the inside travels back through another set of fibers in the pipe. Hence, the image appears on the computer screen. Okay, children. Study well, grow well, be a good citizen and proud to be an Indian. Thank you.